Hello everyone, good morning. One more time, this is part two. The let's work here is a little bad today. So we are reading Hebrews chapter 9. I'm reading the New Living Translation. We are trying to understand today the eternal value of the blood of Jesus, how the blood of Jesus gains its power by the Holy Spirit. So that is what we are studying today. So Hebrews chapter 9, reading from verse 6. When these things were all in place, that is the ark, the tabernacle, were all in place. That's what the preceding verses of Hebrews chapter 6 talk about. So when all these things were in place, the priests regularly entered the first room as they performed their religious duties. But only the high priest ever entered the most holy place, and only once a year. Imagine the high priest who would only enter the most holy place. He could only enter it once a year. But now, as a result of the blood of Jesus, we can come into the most holy place anytime, as many times in the day as we want to. We can enter it. I am so happy about that. So he could only enter once a year, and he always offered blood for his own sins and for the sins the people had committed in ignorance. By these regulations, the Holy Spirit revealed that the entrance to the most holy place was not freely open as long as the tabernacle and the system it represented were still in use. This is an illustration pointing to the present time, for the gifts and sacrifices that the priest offered are not able to cleanse the consciences of the people who bring them. For that old system deals only with food and drink and various cleansing ceremonies, physical regulations that were in effect only until a better system could be established. And this better system is the system of Jesus shedding his blood for us. So verse 11, so Christ has now become the high priest, because the old system was not practical anymore. It was not everlasting. It didn't have any eternal value. So Jesus in verse 11 has now become the high priest over all the good things that have come. He has entered that greater, more perfect tabernacle in heaven, which was not made by human hands and is not part of this created world. With his own blood, not the blood of goats and cows, he entered the most holy place once for all time and secured our redemption forever. Hallelujah. Under the old system, the blood of goats and bulls and the ashes of a heifer could cleanse people's bodies from ceremonial impurity. Verse 14, just think how much more the blood of Christ will purify our consciences from sinful deeds so that we can worship the living God. For by the power of the eternal Spirit, I repeat, for by the power of the eternal Spirit, Christ offered himself to God as a perfect sacrifice to our sins. That is why he is the one who mediates a new covenant between God and people, so that all who are called can receive the eternal inheritance God has promised them. For Christ died to set them free from the penalty of the sins they had committed under that first covenant. Here ends the reading of the Holy Word. So my father says right here in this book that the Holy Spirit imparts a divine value to the blood of Jesus. There are three main ways which the Holy Spirit works through the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus has eternal value as a result of the Holy Spirit. And we see verse 14 that we read, and I now read in King James Version. It says that how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge our conscience from dead works to serve the living God. The blood of Jesus received its power through the Holy Spirit, not through anything else, through the Holy Spirit. And you and I know that the Holy Spirit is God himself. The Holy Spirit is divine. And the Holy Spirit is eternal. That is why when Jesus got the power through the Holy Spirit, the blood of Jesus became imperishable, became incorruptible. And we saw yesterday that we are not bought by corruptible things, no, by the incorruptible blood of Jesus. So the blood of Jesus became incorruptible as a result of it being shed through the eternal Spirit. The Holy Spirit is eternal. The Holy Spirit is valuable. The Holy Spirit is God himself. So there are three main ways which the Holy Spirit works through the blood of Jesus. The first is that the Holy Spirit imparts a divine value to the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus works through the Holy Spirit, not in isolation of the Holy Spirit. It's not like, so if you use the blood of Jesus, then it's outside of God or outside the Holy Spirit. There is no confusion there. It's clear. The blood of Jesus gains its eternal value, its divinity, its eternity through the Holy Spirit. And therefore, the effect of the blood is divine. It's divine. The blood is no longer just a natural substance, but a divine substance. Because it was shed through the Holy Spirit. It gains a divine substance. It is not perishable. It's not, that's why it does not expire. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus does not expire. It is potent and viable, just as it was shed on Calvary over 2,000 years ago. It is as powerful as it is 2,000 years ago. So God and his power are working within that blood to save, to heal, and to do supernatural things in our lives. All we need to do is to plead the blood of Jesus. So number two, the eternal Holy Spirit imparts eternal value to the blood of Jesus. So instead of the blood of Jesus decomposing and decaying, it became a living and eternal thing because of its association with the Holy Spirit. It gains its association, its eternal value, by its association with the Holy Spirit. It is not working in isolation. Hebrews 9 verse 12 says that neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once. That is how powerful it is. It didn't need to be shed twice. It was shed once. So Jesus entered into the holy place once, having obtained eternal redemption for us. The redemption is eternal. When we are saved. Once saved, and that is it. Unless you choose to denounce God. But once you are saved, you are saved. And we constantly need to plead the blood of Jesus for our protection, for our deliverance. We plead the blood of Jesus over our family, over our possessions. I always hear the mandate, pleading the blood of Jesus over us, pleading the blood of Jesus over the cars, over his children, both spiritual and biological, over everything, so that it will be protected. The devil is afraid of the blood of Jesus. We overcame him by the blood of Jesus, the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of our testimony. You remember at one point in time, there was a book, and they were looking for someone to open the book in heaven. Nobody could open the book, so there was cries in heaven. There was a lot of crying and sadness in heaven. But the Lamb that was slain came. He had power to open the book because he shed his blood. The blood of Jesus is powerful here on earth and powerful in heaven. And you and I need to make good use of the blood of Jesus, the power that is in it. Hebrews 10:14 says that, "For by one offering," one, not two, "one offering, he had perfected forever them that are sanctified." Perfected forever. That is why once you confess your sins, you truly repent and you confess your sins and you ask God to wash you and cleanse you of your sins, your sins are washed and God has forgotten it. Bible tells us in Psalms he throws it in the sea of forgetfulness. So you need to forgive yourself as well. You are the only one who is remembering. God does not remember it anymore. He doesn't remember it anymore. He has forgiven you. The blood of Jesus has washed you clean, and you are cleansed indeed. It says that perfected forever them that are sanctified. For by one offering, he has perfected forever. Perfected forever. You and I are perfect, not by works, but by the blood of Jesus. Not by our works, no. Not by our own righteousness, because Bible tells us that our righteousness is as filthy rags. Filthy rags. I am so glad I was born after this dispensation, after the blood of Jesus was shed, because before then in the Old Testament, it had to constantly kill cows, bulls, lamb, and to offer for atonement of their sins. And it was not perfect. It was not perfect, but the blood of Jesus is perfect. It's been shed for us once and for all. Number three, the Holy Spirit brought about the shedding of the blood of Jesus. This is an aspect that we really do not know, and my Father throws great light on it. And I'm going to read this epistle to us. It says that Bishop Daniel Mills says that the blood of Jesus was shed with the help of the Eternal Spirit, with the help of the Eternal Spirit, the Holy Spirit. The scripture teaches that the blood of Christ was offered through the Eternal Spirit. We read that in verse 14 of Hebrews 9. It is the Holy Spirit who worked out all the circumstances. He worked out all the circumstances that resulted in Jesus being crucified and his blood being shed. The Holy Spirit is the mighty power of God that strengthened Jesus Christ during his suffering and crucifixion. Because Jesus could have given up on the cross. Jesus could have decided to demonstrate his power. When they were telling him that, "Physician, heal thyself, save thyself," and all of that. Because Jesus was still God, and he didn't have any sin in him until he decided to take up the sin of the whole world upon himself. He had no sin, he was still God. He could have just swayed his hand and dispatched angels, and they would have sorted all those Roman soldiers out. But the Holy Spirit helped Jesus to go through the pain. Help Jesus to take it all in. Help Jesus not to retaliate, but to go through and share this precious blood for you and I. Somehow, Jesus survived extreme provocation and temptation and was able to shed his blood for mankind. The blood of Jesus Christ was shed through the help of the eternal Holy Spirit. Always remember that the blood of Jesus Christ was shed through the power of the Holy Spirit. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God. Purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Hebrews 9:14. The blood of Jesus has eternal value. Has eternal value. And we need to make good use of the blood of Jesus. What is it that is weighing you down today? Why don't you plead the blood of Jesus? If the blood of Jesus, the Holy Spirit, was able to raise Jesus from the dead, how much more won't the blood of Jesus revive us? How much more won't the blood of Jesus revive us today? There is something I want to read for you. You'll be shocked right here. It is just mind-blowing. Hebrews 13:20. Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant. I read that again. Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant. The scripture teaches that the blood of Jesus is the power that raised Jesus from the dead. Through the blood of the everlasting covenant. The everlasting covenant is the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is what makes the everlasting covenant between us and God the Father. And the scripture tells us that it was through the blood of Jesus that even raised Jesus from the dead, because it had a component. It was shed through the help of the Holy Spirit. So if the blood of Jesus was able to raise him himself from the dead, even though he didn't shed the blood for himself, he shed it for you and I, how much more will the blood of Jesus revive us? Revive every dead situation in our lives. Is there any dead situation going on? All we need to do is to infuse it with the blood of Jesus, and it will be revived and brought back to life. There is hope, my brother and my sister. There is hope. Get this book. Get the Makarios 60 and grab this book out of it. Read it and understand the power that there is in the blood of Jesus. God bless you for taking time out to join us on this morning's broadcast. It is a joy. And I also want you to get the Mantano. The Mantano is 11 textbooks written by my father, Bishop Daniel Mills. In the Mantano is this powerful book, Essential Charismatic Doctrine. Right in there, you have the essential, important doctrines, like the blood of Jesus, the blood power that we need to lay our foundations on. And written beautifully is to help us to be able to use it to teach others as well. So please call the numbers I've scrolled on the screen and get your own Mantano and the Makarios. The Makarios is an elaborate version of the books, and this is concise and written in a way that is effective for teaching. So please call the numbers and get the Mantano and the Makarios today. It will enrich your life and transform you forever. You'll become all that God wants you to become. Don't miss this opportunity to get these anointed books written by my father. It is as a result of exposure to the anointed word that we get impacted. It is by the anointing that the yoke is broken. As the Peter spake, the Spirit fell on people, and there were miracles, and there was salvation. The Spirit entered into me, Ezekiel says in chapter 2:2, the Spirit entered into me as he spake. So please get these books. These books are as a result of my father speaking by the unction of the Holy Spirit and from the scriptures, directly from the scriptures. written in modern English for our understanding and edification and exhortation, reproof and correction. So get these books today and let it bless your life. What you are looking for, what you've been searching all this while, have already been researched, has already been revealed and written in these books. So please get the books today and subscribe to the podcast. The podcast is simply that you are missing, adding you will miss. You'll be exposing yourself to these anointed vessels that God has blessed us with. They are rare gems in our generation. You do not need to be living in this generation and be struggling. There is no point. The mandate's life and my life is easy because of our exposure, allowing ourselves to imbibe into the anointed words of our father and our mother. So please subscribe to the podcast. It will bless your life in ways that words cannot quantify or describe. Subscribe to the podcast and like our page right after this broadcast is over. This is one of our official pages, Quieter with this Monday. The other two official pages is that your Miss Literature Crusade and Peter Bryce Senior hyphen the mandate. Iron sharpeneth iron. The mandate is crystal clear. Therefore, subscribing to his pages and also subscribing to the YouTube channel, The Mandate TV, will help you to get edified, will help you get encouraged, exalted, and your mandate will also be crystal clear to you in the name of Jesus. God bless you as you do all of this, and if you're looking for a place to go take your team out or yourself out to just relax, enjoy the presence of God, have a retreat or go pray, Dynamic, that Yomis International Macarons Empowerment Center, located on Ibadan Ogbomoso Expressway, precisely kilometer 5. It's your one-stop place to do all of that, to hold the conferences, and also to partake in the conferences that we are about to start holding right there. And it's your one-stop place to get all of my father's books and materials as well. Why don't you book today, book ahead of time, infuse it into your schedule for the year, and you'll be so glad you did. God bless you. We look forward to hosting you right there. I see so many of us who have taken time out to join in this morning. God bless you all. I see you right in here. Get to your same day. Dino Fabia Labi, Pastor Henry Amedi, Reverend Tennessee OJ, Rafi Sewami, while the mandate himself, I am so happy to see the mandate. What a joy, I am blessed. And I see right here, Reverend Paul Ama, Amitas Baba, I see Reverend Buku Daniel, Jabulile in Jabulani in Lovu. God bless you all for taking time out to join in, and many others. Share this quiet time, let it bless someone out there. And do not forget to get your own Macarons and Macano today. Don't procrastinate any longer. God bless you so much. I'll see you tomorrow by the special grace of God. I want you to remember that you are a daughter and a son of the Most High God. He created the whole world and everyone and every single thing, and therefore you cannot be a victim of your circumstances. You are a victor. You are more than a conqueror. See you at 6 a.m. GMT plus one tonight.